chemical properties of carbon compounds. Most of the carbon compounds burn in sufficient supply of oxygen to produce carbon dioxide, water, heat, and light. So, simply if I take carbon, it burns in sufficient supply of oxygen. It will form carbon dioxide plus heat plus light. But I said that normally carbon compounds combine with oxygen and produce carbon dioxide, water, heat and light. But since here there is no hydrogen atom present in the given reaction, formation of water molecule is not possible. So now let's take an example of carbon compound. Like for example, methane burns in sufficient supply of oxygen to form carbon dioxide, water, heat and light. Let us balance the reaction. There is one carbon atom on both the sides. There are four hydrogen atoms, but here on the right hand side there are only two hydrogen atoms. So I will balance by putting two as a coefficient. So hydrogen becomes 2 2s are 4. On the left hand side there are two oxygen atoms, whereas on the right hand side there are 2 plus 2 4 oxygen atoms. Therefore I will put two coefficient in front of O2. So the reaction is balanced. Now if I take, so this is methane. Methane burns in sufficient supply of oxygen to form carbon dioxide, water, heat and light. Let me take the next alkane, that is ethane. Ethane burns in sufficient supply of oxygen to form carbon dioxide, water, heat plus light. So let us balance the reaction once again. Now here you can see there are two atoms of carbon, but here there is only one atom of carbon. So if I put two here, then carbon has got balanced. Hydrogen, there are six atoms. So if I put three here, hydrogen is also balanced, but now count the number of oxygen atoms. There are 2 2s are 4 oxygen atoms plus here we have 3 oxygen atoms. That means there are 7 oxygen atoms. And if you want to balance oxygen on the left hand side, here this being an odd number, it is not possible. That means our balancing for oxygen should have an even coefficient. That means this coefficient is completely wrong. So I will have to increase the number of carbon atoms. Here I had 2 carbon atoms. So I will put 2 coefficient in front of C2H6. So carbon atoms have become 4. Okay. So now if carbon has become 4, on the right hand side also I will have to balance by putting 4 in front of CO2. See, there are 6 2s are 12 hydrogen atoms. That means I will have to put 6 H2O. So 6 2s are 12. Now count the number of oxygen atoms. So here we have 8 oxygen atoms and here we have 6 oxygen atoms. So total there are 14 oxygen atoms. That means I will have to put 7 O2. So the reaction is balanced. So in general, whenever carbon compounds burn in sufficient supply of oxygen, the products formed are carbon dioxide, water, heat and light. Now I have shown you two reactions with alkanes. I will show you one reaction with alkene. So suppose if I say that C2H4, this is ethene, combines with oxygen in sufficient supply, it combines in sufficient supply of oxygen to form carbon dioxide, water, heat plus light. Okay, so this is ethene. This was methane, an alkane. This was ethane. And now I have taken an alkene, that is ethene. So CO2 plus H2O plus heat plus light is formed. Now, since there are two carbon atoms here, if I balance carbon on the right hand side by putting two coefficient, then hydrogen is 4. So if I put 2 here, you will find that there are 4 oxygen atoms plus 2 oxygen atoms on the right hand side. So 4 plus 2, 6. That means I can put coefficient 3 on the left hand side for oxygen, so that oxygen gets balanced on both the sides. Okay, so it's not only with the alkanes. Even with the alkenes, you will find that Alkenes burn in sufficient supply of oxygen to form carbon dioxide, water, heat and light. Now let me take an example of alcohol. Suppose I say I take ethyl alcohol, CH3CH2OH, any carbon compound, when it burns in sufficient supply of oxygen, the product is same, HCO2 plus H2O plus heat plus light. So this is ethyl alcohol, CH3CH2OH. It burns in sufficient supply of oxygen. Byproducts are same, as you can see on the right hand side. So once again, let us balance the equation. There are two atoms of carbon on the left hand side. So on the right hand side, I will balance carbon. See how many hydrogen atoms are there on the left. 3 plus 2, 4, 5, 5 plus 1, 6. So I can put 3 here. So 3 2s are 6. Count the number of oxygen atoms. 2 plus 1, 3. So here I have how many? 3 oxygen atoms plus 2 2s are 4 oxygen atoms. So 7 are there. 7 are there. So here already I have 1. So I can put 3 here. So 3 2s are 6. 6 plus 1, 7. So the reaction is balanced. See, I said the hydrocarbons burn in sufficient supply of air or oxygen to form carbon dioxide, water, heat and light. Now, if the air is not sufficient, that is, if the hydrocarbons are burning in insufficient supply of air or oxygen, then the products formed will be different. Specifically, saturated hydrocarbons, they burn in insufficient supply of air or oxygen to form carbon monoxide and water. What are saturated hydrocarbons? They are alkanes. So, if I take an alkane like methane, and if methane burns in insufficient supply of air or oxygen, the products formed will be carbon monoxide plus water, that is CO plus H2O. Now, let me balance balance carbon on both the sides. So we'll see, if you are counting the number of carbon atoms, there is one carbon atom on both the sides. Hydrogen is 4, your hydrogen is 2. So suppose if I put 2 here in front of hydrogen, so hydrogen becomes 4. If you are balancing oxygen, here there are 2 oxygen atoms, but on the right hand side there are 2 plus 1, 3 oxygen atoms. So 3 being an odd number, it is not possible to balance oxygen on the left hand side. That means this coefficient 2 that we have put is a wrong coefficient. Okay, so CO plus, let me write it once again, CO plus H2O. So let me put 2 in front of CH4. So if there are 2 carbon atoms on the left hand side, I will have to put 2 in front of CO. So carbon is balanced. Hydrogen has become 2 4s are 8. So I can put 4 here, 4 2s are 8. Count the number of oxygen atoms on the right hand side. 2 plus 4, 4 oxygen, 6. So I can put 3 here, the reaction gets balanced. Similarly, if I take ethane, that is C2H6, C saturated hydrocarbon burns in insufficient supply of air or oxygen to form carbon monoxide plus water, that is CO plus H2O. So now if I put 2 here in front of C2H6, 2 2s are 4, so I'll put 4 here. Hydrogen is 6, 2s are 12, so I can put 6 high water molecules. Oxygen has become 4 plus 6, 10, that means I can put 5O2. So this is the reaction of saturated hydrocarbon with oxygen, but it is in insufficient supply of air or oxygen. If the supply of oxygen is still less, then saturated hydrocarbon, they burn in still limited supply of air, and that leads to incomplete combustion and a sooty flame is formed. So methane burns in still insufficient supply of oxygen. So oxygen supply is very, very less for combustion. So incomplete combustion of saturated hydrocarbons will take place. So now see, in the first case, when oxygen was in sufficient quantity, carbon dioxide was formed. When oxygen is in insufficient quantity, carbon monoxide is formed. But if oxygen is very, very insufficient, then instead of carbon monoxide, carbon will be formed. Along with carbon, now water will be formed. So H2O will be formed. So here you can see there are 4 hydrogen atoms, 2H2O, oxygen is already balanced. So this carbon leads to formation of soot or carbon particles. One more point to be kept in mind is that whenever saturated hydrocarbons burn, then they burn with a clean blue flame. But when unsaturated hydrocarbons burn, then you can see they burn with a yellow flame. And when they do so, they produce a lot of smoke. And this smoke contains carbon particles. And this is called as soot. You can check out the reaction. I have already told you that when saturated hydrocarbons burn in still insufficient supply of air or oxygen, then incomplete combustion takes place, giving rise to a sooty flame. So the reaction is shown with methane, CH4, burns in insufficient supply of oxygen to form carbon particles along with water molecules. Another thing that you have noticed at home is that the gas burner at home has small openings, and these openings are inlets for air to pass in, so that when LPG gas reaches the burner, the oxygen from the air mixes with the LPG gas in sufficient amount. And so when the flame is produced, when we burn the gas, is a blue flame, as you can see in the image. But sometimes some particles get collected in the inlets of the burner, yani kachra jama ho jata hai burner mein. So when we light the burner, the inlets are choked. Therefore, there is insufficient supply of oxygen to the LPG gas, and the LPG gas does not burn completely. And we notice that at that time, we find that the flame which comes out from the burner is a yellow flame. Also, we find soot particles are produced. And how do I know that soot particles are produced? Because if I keep a vessel on the gas, I find some black colored particles sticking to the surface or to the bottom of the vessel, which is kept on the burner. So these are the unburned carbon particles which are produced by the incomplete combustion of the fossil fuel, that is the LPG gas. The second chemical reaction that we are going to study is the oxidation reaction. In the previous reactions, that is in combustion, we have seen that carbon compounds can easily combine with the oxygen which is present in the air when we burn them or when we ignite them. And during the process of combustion, all chemical bonds which are present in the molecule of the carbon compounds break, and we have seen that carbon dioxide and water is formed. So in the process of combustion, the source of oxygen is air. But there are some chemical compounds also which can be used as a source of oxygen. That is, the air is not going to supply oxygen for the process of burning, but it is the chemical compounds or the chemical substances which can provide oxygen for the process of burning. And such compounds or such substances which supply oxygen to other substances are called as oxidants or oxidizing agents. Some of the commonly used oxidizing agents are potassium permanganate and potassium dichromate. We have already seen this in chapter number 3, that is types of chemical reactions. Let us watch a video in order to understand oxidation reaction. This video is made by studycloud.com, and in the video we are going to study the oxidation of ethanol.
Ethanol, dilute solution of sodium carbonate, dilute solution of potassium permanganate, tincture iodine solution. A. Oxidation of ethanol. 1. Take 2 to 3 ml of ethanol in a test tube. Add 5 ml of sodium carbonate solution to it. Warm the mixture. Two, add a few drops of the dilute solution of potassium permanganate to the warm mixture with constant stirring. Three, observe the change in the pink color of potassium permanganate immediately after its addition started. Observations. 1. When a solution of potassium permanganate is added to ethanol, in the beginning, the pink color disappears. 2. When addition is continued further, the pink color does not vanish but remains as it is.
So, in the experiment, we have seen that 2 to 3 ml of ethanol was taken in a test tube. 5 ml of sodium carbonate was added to it and the solution was warmed on the burner. Potassium permanganate was added drop wise to the warm mixture. We noticed that in the beginning, when potassium permanganate was added, the pink color of the potassium permanganate disappeared. This is because potassium permanganate is used up in the oxidation reaction. Now, if more potassium permanganate is added to the solution, then at a certain point of addition, oxidation of the entire ethanol which is present in the test tube is completed. So, if further addition of potassium permanganate is done beyond a certain point, we find that potassium permanganate is not used up, but that KMnO4 becomes excess. And therefore, the pink color of potassium permanganate does not vanish, but it stays as it is. This is the reaction for oxidation of ethanol. Once again, let me remind you, we have already studied this particular reaction in third chapter. Here, ethanol, that is CH3CH2OH, is oxidized in presence of KMnO4 to form ethanoic acid, that is CH3COOH. So when alcohols undergo oxidation, then carboxylic acids are formed. The third reaction is the addition reaction. Addition reaction takes place only in unsaturated compounds, that is in alkenes and alkynes. Alkenes contain carbon to carbon double bond, alkynes contain carbon to carbon triple bond. So addition reaction is a characteristic reaction of only unsaturated hydrocarbons. In this reaction, one carbon compound gets added to another compound and the product form will contain all the atoms of the reactants. So such a reaction is called as addition reaction. Let us study addition reaction with the help of an example. This is a very, very important short note which is asked for 3 marks, wherein you will have to write down the definition of addition reaction for 1 mark. That is, when a carbon compound combines with another compound to form a product that contains all the atoms in both the reactants, then the reaction is called as addition reaction. The second point is very important, wherein you will mention that addition reaction takes place only in unsaturated hydrocarbons which contain carbon to carbon double bond and carbon to carbon triple bond. The example will carry 1 mark. Here the example is that if ethene reacts with bromine, pure liquid bromine, and that too in cold conditions in the presence of an organic solvent like tetrachloromethane, then we find that the reddish brown color of bromine disappears and the solution obtained is colorless. In this reaction, the double bond between carbon to carbon breaks and each of the bromine atom gets attached to the carbon atom and a compound called as 1,2-dibromoethane is formed. Let us see the reaction for addition reaction. What are the points that are specified? That addition reaction takes place only in unsaturated hydrocarbons. Why? If it is alkene, there is carbon to carbon double bond, so it's an unsaturated hydrocarbon, and if it is an alkyne, it contains carbon to carbon triple bond. So what happens during addition reaction? The carbon to carbon double bond breaks and a single bond is formed between two carbon atoms. If it is a triple bond, the carbon to carbon triple bond breaks to form a carbon to carbon single bond in the addition reaction. So I took the example of ethene CH2 double bond CH2. When bromine is added to ethene, then the carbon to carbon double bond breaks in between these two carbon atoms and a single bond is formed. So this hydrogen, here we have two hydrogen atoms. So I will place two hydrogen atoms here. One bromine gets attached with one carbon atom. If I take the second carbon atom, there are two hydrogen atoms linked on it. So I can show two hydrogen atoms here. And the next place of carbon will be satisfied with bromine. So this becomes 1,2-dibromoethane. Because there are two carbon atoms, therefore your root word will be eth. And it's an alkane because there is a carbon to carbon single bond. So it's 1,2-dibromoethane. Also note that bromine has reddish brown color. But when it is added to ethene, the reddish brown color disappears and the entire solution becomes colorless. And in the definition, we are saying that when carbon compound is added to another compound, then we find that the final product will contain all the atoms which are present on the reactant side. Okay. Let us see addition of a carbon compound with hydrogen. When ethene and hydrogen gas are passed over a catalyst like nickel at 200 degrees Celsius, we find that the double bond between the two carbon atoms break to form a single bond, and this hydrogen, these two atoms of hydrogen, let me show the attachment of these two hydrogens on the initial carbon atoms. But what has happened here, because of addition of hydrogen, the carbon to carbon double bond has broken and the unsaturated hydrocarbon has been converted into a saturated hydrocarbon. See, the valency of carbon is not satisfied here. So there are two atoms of hydrogen. So one atom of hydrogen will get attached here and one atom will get attached here, and ethane will be formed. So what has happened here in addition of hydrogen reaction? When hydrogen is added to a carbon compound, the unsaturated hydrocarbon has been converted into a saturated hydrocarbon. So this reaction of addition of hydrogen to a carbon compound is called as hydrogenation reaction. Now let's see addition of halogens to carbon compounds. So this is another addition reaction wherein we are going to add halogens to the carbon compound. So if we consider once again ethene and a halogen like chlorine, that is this halogen ethene is treated with chlorine at room temperature, then once again the carbon to carbon double bond will break. Single bond will be formed. So unsaturated hydrocarbon has been converted into saturated hydrocarbon. We'll show attachment of these two hydrogen atoms. Here also H2. So these two hydrogen atoms will get attached here. And what will happen to this chlorine? One chlorine atom will get attached with one carbon and another chlorine will get attached with this carbon. So what will happen here? There are two carbon atoms. So 1,2-dichloroethane will be formed. This reaction of addition of a halogen to a carbon compound is called as halogenation reaction. The next reaction is substitution reaction. Normally in saturated hydrocarbons, we find that there are carbon hydrogen and carbon to carbon single bond. And both these bonds, that is carbon to hydrogen and carbon to carbon bonds, are very strong. So under normal conditions, saturated hydrocarbons are not reactive. And therefore, they remain inert in presence of most of the reagents. However, we find that saturated hydrocarbons react rapidly with chlorine in the presence of sunlight. And what happens during this reaction is that one after the other, the hydrogen atoms are replaced with the chlorine atoms in the saturated hydrocarbon. So let us see chlorination of methane. So methane is CH4. Chlorination means we are going to show addition of chlorine. And this reaction takes place in the presence of sunlight. Okay, now this is a substitution reaction. That means if I am drawing the structural formula of methane, it will be like this, plus chlorine will be like this. Now chlorine being more reactive, it will displace one atom of hydrogen from the methane molecule, and this place of hydrogen now will be taken by chlorine. So now what will happen here is CHHH. One hydrogen will be substituted, the place will be taken by chlorine, and where will this hydrogen go? It will form hydrogen chloride. Okay, So I can write this reaction as CH4 plus Cl2 in the presence of sunlight will give CH3Cl. So CH3Cl plus HCl will be formed. Now there is only one carbon atom and chlorine is attached to one carbon atom. So this will be chloromethane because there is only one carbon atom. So that root word will be meth and the suffix will be ane. So this will be chloromethane. So I'll write down the name of this compound as chloromethane. CH3Cl is chloromethane. The reaction does not stop here. Chloromethane, that is CH3Cl, will continue reacting with chlorine in the presence of sunlight because there are more hydrogen atoms in CH3Cl. So now once again, if I draw the structure of CH3Cl plus Cl2 like this, once again now this chlorine will displace or will substitute another hydrogen atom. Okay, so when substitution of this hydrogen suppose takes place, then instead of hydrogen here we will show chlorine and this hydrogen will combine with this chlorine to form HCl. So now here two chlorine atoms are attached to one carbon atom. So this is dichloromethane. So dichloromethane will be formed. What is the formula? CH2Cl2. So CH2Cl2 will be formed plus HCl. So I will write down the name of the compound as dichloromethane. Chloromethane. The reaction still continues further, because there are still two more hydrogen atoms left in the reaction. So CH2Cl2 plus Cl2 in the presence of sunlight. So now I am going to write down the reaction directly. One hydrogen will be substituted and one chlorine will be added here. So this will be CHCl3 plus HCl. This is trichloromethane. This is also called as chloroform. One more reaction is possible because there is one more hydrogen atom, CHCl3 plus Cl2 in the presence of sunlight will form CCl4 plus HCl. This is tetrachloromethane. Tetrachloromethane is also called as carbon tetrachloride. So CHCl3 is chloroform and CCl4 is carbon tetrachloride. So when methane reacts with chlorine in the presence of sunlight, a mixture of chloromethane, dichloromethane, trichloromethane and tetrachloromethane is obtained.